In this tutorial, I'll show you how to add physics to a particle animation scene. In this example, the particle meshes are being dropped on the floor by an emitter. The bouncing meshes then settle to slide away. There are three meshes in total. One cube and two planes. For the ground mesh, I create a plane and typed S to scale. Here are the material settings. Basically, I have used a dark metallic material with low roughness. Please use EV with bloom. I created a cube, typed S to scale, and S and X to scale on the X axis. Here are the full nodes for the particle mesh. I'll show you the emitter mesh's particle setting details. The particles will last for 250 frames long. Please experiment with the rest of the settings to have the best looking result. The velocity's rotation will control how the initial particles meshes will be distributed. Higher numbers, the wider angles. The rotation settings randomize option will allow us to randomly self-rotate every particle mesh being generated. Please remember to use the cube with random colors as the instance object. The bounciness and the slippery ground settings are being controlled by the ground mesh's collision physics. Here are my settings. I'll show you what each collision value does to the animation. Under the collision setting, there are only a couple of settings that will visually affect the end result. The permeability will control how many particles will pass through. Higher the stickiness, less the bounciness. Kill particles will immediately remove any particles being in contact with the ground mesh. There are a lot more features to explore and a lot of them are self-explanatory. To learn more about what each setting does, please hover the mouse cursor over the setting value regions. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.